For Severine and Kamel Almeni, the war in Syria is personal. It began the day their 17-year-old daughter, Sarah, carrying two bulky school bags, left her home in the south of France for the war-torn country.
It's just crazy. The problem is that we are powerless.
Sarah took the train from her home in the village of Lezion-Corbière to Marseille, where she caught a flight to Istanbul. From there, she ended up with the Islamic State group in Syria. The family believes Islamic militants coached Sarah.
It is a psychological kidnapping because they are being watched. I don't know for how long Sarah has been indoctrinated via the internet.
Using social media, online jihadist networks are recruiting vulnerable young girls to serve as wives and housekeepers for their fighters. Sarah was a typical target. She started to wear the full Muslim veil, dropped out of school for 6 months, closing herself in her room with a computer.
She was spending a lot of time on the internet, but they must have told her various things, done some brainwashing.
Since she left, Sarah's family has spoken to her briefly 3 times, including once when she told them she's now married to a 25-year-old Tunisian living in Syria.
She repeated 3 times the same thing, "Where am I?" before saying, "I am in Syria." In fact, it was as if she were waiting for the green light from the person next to her to tell us she was in Syria.
Sarah's parents are distraught. France is on the verge of passing a law which will treat people who join jihadists as terrorists, facing arrest upon return.
I will do everything possible so that my daughter comes home, and when she gets home, there will be a second battle with the French government, that's for sure. My daughter, a terrorist?
Ma fille, une terroriste.
Sarah joins hundreds of schoolgirl jihadis who have left for Syria, 100 or more from France alone.
They don't find any room for them in the Republic, and they just are looking for something else. And most part of them come back and are very disappointed.
Sarah's parents do not know how, if at all, the police investigation into her disappearance is progressing. Under French law, authorities are not allowed to release details of investigations until a case goes to trial. Tracy Brown, Associated Press.